have with me in the studio Mr. Taiwo Omotunde, the governor of Performing Musicians Association of Nigeria, PMAN, in Oyo State. Sir, as the governor of PMAN, what have you been doing to attract more investors to invest in musicians that are resident in Oyo State? Because if money and the investment seems to be going to Lagos. So what have you been doing to at least pull in a bit of difference in this aspect?
Bring all musicians together under the dedication of us. Let the society also be in that point. Is to put every forward to see what they can do. We're going to improve our website now, which we have to talk about, so that we can just take artists, just musicians into the world, make the world. It's a human, yes, but it's which is a major development. One, it will create a database of when we approach the government to know who they are talking to. They are talking to 2,500 people at the same time. Who have offices, who are known to have offices.
And how would you describe the support of the state government while you have since you've been under the mantle of leadership in PMAN?
Well, let me tell you, when I became governor in 2018, I think about January 2019, myself and my secretary, we came to see the Minister of Culture. And you know that they have never heard about PMAN before.
Wow.
So I cannot blame them. There was no interface between the association and them. In fact, when I went to the Federal Ministry of Information and the Federal Secretariat, when I presented our said that we are the PMAN is a trade union. They couldn't believe until I presented the certificate. So we are just getting around to talking to them now. So the assistance I've gotten from, let me say we as a body have gotten from the government is near zero.
Wow.
But then look at it, recently we had a collaboration with the cultural center. We visited them. They are now known to us and we are now known to them. So we are beginning to explore possibilities with the government, because the music industry is vast and we can help the government and the government can help us. We have the capacity, we have, you know, when you are talking about a musician, you are talking about someone who holds a microphone and controls millions of people. So even for policy, for mobilization, for policy effectiveness, you need musicians. The government needs musicians to help in mobilizing people. We also need the government. Look at it, the government is losing revenue. If we are well organized in that sector, do you know that for every performance you pay some form of tax to the government? But when you are not known and people recording are not known to the government, the studios are not known, what they are producing is not, it's not known. It cannot be estimated, cannot be calculated in terms of excise duty payment to the government for production and all these things. But I believe that very soon we are making effort now to see if we can see Mr. Governor and present, give our proposal on how to develop the industry. If the entertainment industry is developed in Oyo State, it will, as I assure you, it can help double the IGR of the state. That's it.
Aside from having the governor's attention,
yes,
what type of support are you looking at getting?
Well, you know, we are professionals. We are not saying someone should come and give us some money to be able to drink palm wine or anything. We are looking for infrastructural development, whereby the government puts up, help with our collaboration, puts up a festival. Maybe twice a year it will occur. And people will come. We do not have that kind of money to organize that kind of issue. If we collaborate with government, you know, for the if it's a week that the festival will take, everybody in Oyo State will be there in that week. The government can get people influenced that 1 week. For instance, if we are singing about don't fight or anything, I'm just saying that. You know, we get people to listen to us because we are leaders of society in our own right. So it will be of mutual benefit. We want the government to pay attention to us. We want to be able to talk to them. We are what we call the SMEs, you know, the small and medium scale enterprise. We musicians are not at the moment reckoned as part of, but we are. Imagine if I have 30 people in my band that I employ, that I feed, and you have thousands of, let's even be modest and say you have 1,000 musicians in your state. And then they all have bands. You do know how we work around the employment industry, the employment market, how we can help that area. So, but see, for example, let me tell you, availability of equipment and infrastructure for music is very expensive now. Because, and sometimes people are discouraged. The musicians are just to relax and go and find something else to do. Because the recording studios are no longer there. The label owners are no longer there, and then it's not yet the digital platforms are not yet covering the state very well. So we have to deal with people. How do you do that with limited funds? If the government will come in and help us reorganize that area, the government will have revenue. We will also enjoy our career.
Exactly. When you were speaking the other time, you made mention of developing the website for the association.
It's ongoing.
That is ongoing. Yeah. Aside from this website development, which we know to be one of the modern infrastructures in technological advancement, what are the other things that you are doing to modernize Oyo State music?
Yes, for instance, now we are in terms of training and general mobilization. We are at the association level getting musicians to be aware of possibilities in the industry, bringing people who are experts to talk to them about the digitization of their music, about polarization, about expansion and distribution, and even recovery and repatriation of royalties. We are talking to musicians about that. Musicians are now more aware of their rights. That if you play my record, you're supposed to pay something. If you buy my record, you should pay, and then something should come back to me from the distributor. So people are beginning to ask questions from people who market their stuff. Unlike before, where they take the money, they take the art, the musician is left with nothing. So the association is working very well in that area now. And people's awareness have been heightened. That's a major one.
Now, speaking on revenue generation
and
lifestyle of musicians,
yes.
If you look vividly, we tend to have otherwise. I mean, we tend to have it the other way around.
Yes.
Musicians, now, by the time you visit their social media pages or see them outside, they tend to live luxury lifestyles.
Yes.
And people are of the opinion that musicians are rich. And from what you've just said, musicians are lagging behind in revenue generation and how they should be earning from their craft.
Yes.
And would you say musicians in Oyo State are really as rich as how they portray themselves?
No, when you say we portray ourselves, that sounds as if we are deceiving people. We are not. You see, how many websites have we visited? The truth is that musicians are not even in the public land. They are not well publicized. They are underreported. So, musicians in Oyo State are in obscurity. That's the truth of the matter. Because if you want to, unlike here now, where you are very civil and then you have done what is right, in other places, you will not feature anyone except that person pays. The commercialization of this industry, of the media, has helped in killing the effort of musicians and all the artists. You know, those our guys, this Sonny Ade, Ike Dairo, all of them were made by the media in terms of promotion and feature. But now you have to have money yourself to be able to promote your music to radio stations. That's a disservice.
Now, speaking of this promotion, yes. I didn't really want to go deep into the issue of promotion and radio airplays, TV airplays, and others.
Yeah.
Now, there's this issue that has personally been bothering me, the issue of payola. Payola is a system whereby you go to a radio station, you pay for your music to be played, like you rightly said, and the music is being paid according to the highest bidder.
Yes.
What would you advise the media on this? And how would you say this is supposed to be restructured to have it back in the days that we had a situation whereby musicians will come, drop their CDs to the radio station, and they will play it from their free mind and give them the total airplay they really deserve?
Yes. Now, it is the business of the media owners, of the radio station owners, to give a kind of policy direction in this area. That this station wants to help with the cultural development and all that, which includes music. But you see, the problem is that the way we find ourselves in Nigeria now is that the radio stations themselves are over-commercialized. In other words, every minute, every hour is reckoned in terms of money returns. So they give instructions to people to buy airtime from them.
But
the presenters also must make profit. The presenters who have bought that hour will now think in terms of ripping from the promoters of their product. For instance, the people who want their records played, who want their adverts placed. So it is the problem with the ownership, with the direction of that institution, and we are having it. More people are doing freelance broadcasting now. More people, they buy airtime. So won't they get their money? I don't blame them. So whatever they can do to recoup the money they are given to that station, they will do it, whether it is ethical or not. But it is wrong to expect that we will pay people to play our music. We are right, it should be the other way around. When you play music, you have to pay the right to the company that you remit the thing to me. In fact, when I hear my music on record, on radio, I should be expecting some payment. That's paying the, you see, the rights of ownership belongs to me. It is my craft, it's my art, it is what is called intellectual property. So when you use my property without compensating me, you have made shown me the lost side of life, and that's why musicians are poor. On the other hand, also you see musicians copying themselves. So when you copy other people, you are releasing records of other people. So who owns the right? And if you are smarter and you are richer, you may have registered that music without before the original owner. So it's a multifaceted problem.
Now, still on the issue of the radio stations and media houses, do you think the policy should be sent out from the media houses themselves, or should be addressed by the NCC?
You see, we have multiplicity of agencies. That's the problem. You see, the Ministry of Information is the one controlling such things. You forget about those thrusters, those sub-agencies. The Minister of Information and Culture, Abi, the Commissioner for Information and Culture, is supposed to rule over those terrain. So it is for instance, in your state, the government should give instruction to the commissioner. The commissioner should give instruction to the that in this state, this is what should happen between the entertainers and the media. That is what is. Are we not a federating unit?
Exactly.
And also, we can do our things there. And if we do it, we'll be, you know, we are pay setters. So if we are pay setters, we do the right thing and other people will follow. And it comes from the fact that everything is wiped or upside down. You see, before, what they call them artist managers of these radio stations will move around and look for musicians who are coming up and say in their board, we are promoting 10 of these people in this quarter. We are promoting 5 of them this other quarter. As a matter of social duty, say you get it. Yeah. Oh, but now, if you don't have money at your emission and you are gifted, you are just there. And don't forget that there are no more recording labels.
Okay. Everybody has gone.
No, it's not only that. They left because it was no longer profitable for them. And when the Nigerianization of those industries were done in 1976, we became the owners of those recording labels, Decca and so on. We couldn't manage them. Don't forget that we don't produce the raw materials here for discs and for records. So are we not jinxed?
So now, you made mention of radio houses sourcing out for new and emerging talent.
Yes.
As their social responsibility duty to the
Correct.
People.
Yes.
Now, by the time we look at most of the songs that are being played on radio stations, hardly will you listen to 10 of the songs that are from Oyo State. I'm not saying from overseas now.
Yes.
Most of these musicians that they play their songs on radio stations in Oyo State,
yes.
This is not an attack on them.
Yes.
But it's just, let's just establish the fact and say it live.
You are correct.
Now, most of those songs are coming from Lagos.
Yes.
In Oyo State.
Yes.
Now, how would you address this? Like, you have artists in Oyo State,
yes.
Because they don't have the financial capacity of those that are in other states.
Yes.
You are favoriting the people that are in other states,
yes.
Ahead of the ones that are where you are domiciled.
It is a problem. You are correct. You have done the research, and that's the truth. You see, because our things don't interest us. If you have a musician sourced from UI or from Bodija, advertised are playing at a particular function, no one will go there. If he says from Abuja or Lagos or Prako, then everyone will go. So, and it is because of the fundamental thing that musicians that are not known cannot draw the crowd. And it is the media who makes musicians. So if there's a way the government can persuade or influence the policies of this station in Oyo State to concentrate more on the locals, in 5 years' time, you will have those locals become international stars.
Exactly, I agree with you.
That's it. You cannot. There's no other way. And that's why even in P-Man, we are imbuing their minds now with self-confidence. Say, look, you can do it. Your music is good. Get a good producer for your music. Don't produce it just like that. Get employed producers who can make it standard, and your music will stand shoulder to shoulder with those in Lagos or in Port Harcourt. Yes, the figure is in Lagos. I mean, in terms of people, in terms of event centers, in terms of those infrastructural developments that music needs is already in Lagos. But Ibadan is not bad. Ibadan is not bad. We also have the people here, the population. What we need is to work more. Okay, I was very glad when I saw that Culture Center is now being used. You know, that top is now being used as a kind of a gathering center for music, for entertainment. And that one is in business area. And all these things that government is doing, because it's government that is doing those stuff, it is to engage the young people, not only even the young people, the population generally, into the habit of going out to enjoy themselves.
Recreation.
And to see the arts. When you go out like that, then the artists become known to them. And if their music is online, then they buy it. But to say that people will go and buy or patronize musicians that are not known. Like, I know, you have to be known. So to be known now is a problem, because many people who are very good musicians cannot be known because they don't have the funds to promote themselves. In those days, you used to have promoters who work with label owners, who are given contracts to promote this person, take him to shows in the universities, in the colleges, make him popular. But now no one is doing that anymore. So it's only, and the kind of resources that is needed can only be found with government. If the government announces today that they want to do 2 weeks festival of music in Italy, and they will do another one in Shaki and so on, and they collaborate with us, then we can make it happen. That the Oyo State government will recover the funds that they have invested At the same time, they must have made stars out of the concert. And don't Gomez should not think it's a wasted effort, because even when there is a show in town, everybody's going there. You see less crime.
Exactly.
You know, people are there, they are busy with that event, that they won't think about going to rob another person. I'm not saying audiences or musicians are criminal, but what I'm saying is that, you see, when the idle mind is the devil's workshop, when you have things to do, you take your partner, or you go and see a slimmer, or you go and see a musician playing, you won't think of going to rob another person. And then, you know, there are associated industries, which emerges with this event. For instance, if you are going to do a festival, look at the new coach, stadium that's being
inaugurated.
The new stadium is going to be a tourist center. So if we organize the musical festival there, you know that all the shops and other places we sell.
Exactly.
Then the food vendors we sell, the hotels we sell, the people who want to design clothes we sell, transportation we sell. So music is not just enjoyment, it's just not a waste of time. It's commercial art, and the government should realize that. You know, in the Second World War, you know, it was the Beatles. The Beatles, they were, that's the name of a band in a group in UK. You do know that they contributed to the recovery of UK from depression, because all over the world they were going for concerts, and then they were repatriating their royalties from record sales in foreign exchange. Do you know how many how much money musicians have brought to this nation? You can't.
Exactly.
If you research it, you will know it's not a joke.
They've
all over the world, that is Nigerian music that is ready. Exactly. So they contribute to our GDP, they contribute to our foreign earnings, and yet the government does not consider music as a department, as something to work on, as a section of the economy generating the activity of this country. That's it.
Well, so far you've been listening to Mr. Taiwo Omotunde, the president of P-Man, the governor of P-Man in Oyo State.